All right, so this is intermediate equation solving. Specifically, we're going to talk about the U substitution strategy for solving an equation. The U substitution comes in handy when you have a single trig function and either a double angle in the parentheses, or sometimes you might have something other than a double angle. But what we're going to do is, and let me stress this too, before we start this, you can always find the solution to an equation by graphing the left-hand side of the equation, and then also graphing the right-hand side of the equation, and find out where those two graphs intersect. So if we take y equals sine of 2x and y equals radical 3 over 2, and let's say I just want to find out where the solutions are between 0 and 2 pi, I can see just by clicking one of the solutions is going to be pi over 6, the other one's going to be pi over 3, a third one is going to be 7 pi over 6, a fourth, 4 pi over 3. I could go over here to 13 pi over 6, but that would be past 2 pi, right? 12 pi over 6 is 2 pi, so 13 pi over 6 is a little bit over that. Same is true down here. I could go negative 2 pi over 3, but that's not between 0 and 2 pi. So I'm looking for these four answers. And we're going to show you how to do that using U substitution. So we're going to let U equal 2x. And by doing that, then, I have the sine of U to equal radical 3 over 2. Using the unit circle, then I can say, okay, if sine of U is radical 3 over 2, then U has to be equal to pi over 3. That's in quadrant 1. Sine is also positive in quadrant 2, so u is going to equal 2 pi over 3. Now, all the solutions would be pi over 3 plus 2 pi k, or 2 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k. That represents all the solutions, not just the ones from 0 to 2 pi. If you don't understand that, go back to the previous video on basic equation solving. All right, let's resubstitute our u equals 2x. So now I have 2x equals pi over 3 plus 2 pi k, and 2x equals 2 pi over 3 plus 2 pi k. And now we got to solve this for x, right? So we can divide everything by 2, or it might be easier to see if we just multiply by 1/2. So if I distribute the 1/2 through, that gives me pi over 6 plus pi k. 1/2 times pi over 3 is pi over 6. 1/2 times 2 pi k is just pi k. Over here, I can do the same thing. I'm going to multiply by 1/2, multiply both sides by 1/2. Squeeze that in there. So those are going to reduce. And then I get x equals, again, pi over 3. Pi over 3 plus 3 plus pi k. All right. Now, we have to, since we're finding stuff from 0 to 2 pi, and by the way, k is going to be an integer. K is an integer. There's some notation here that you might see, or that, you know, it's worth talking about here. When I say k is the set of all integers, z represents the set of all integers. So k is any integer that is in this entire set of integers. So let's just play the game here. Let's let k equal 0. Let's start with 0. If k equals 0, then x is going to be pi over 6 plus pi times 0. Well, that's just going to be pi over 6. And since pi over 6 is between 0 and 2 pi, we're going to say that that is one of our solutions. What happens if we let k equal 1? Well, if we let k equal 1, then x equals pi over 6 plus pi times 1. Well, that's the same thing as pi over 6 plus 6 pi over 6. So x equals 7 pi over 6, which is between 0 and 2 pi, so that's another one of my solutions. What happens if I let k equal 2? Well, then I'm going to get pi over 6 plus pi times 2 plus 2 pi. Well, we can see, just using logic here, what if I take 2 pi plus pi over 6, that's going to give me something. So x is going to be greater than x is going to be greater than 2 pi here if I add that together. It's going to be 13 pi over 6. And that's beyond the 2 pi limit. So I don't need k equals 2 here. So right now, the way it stands, I have two of my solutions, pi over 6 and 7 pi over 6. All right, well, to find the remaining solutions, I need to do the same thing over here. We're going to let k equal 0. And I'm going to say x equals pi over 3 plus pi times 0, which is just going to be pi over 3. That's between 0 and 2 pi. So I'll take that for one of my answers. Let's see what happens if k equals 1. That's going to give me pi over 3 plus pi times 1. Well, pi over 3 plus 3 pi over 3, that's 4 pi over 3, which is legit. That's between 0 and 2 pi. If I let k equal 2, just like we had before, what's going to happen is x is going to equal pi over 3 plus pi times 2 plus 2 pi. Well, we can see that that's going to be greater than 2 pi. X is greater than 2 pi. In that case, I don't need it because I'm specifically looking for answers that are between 0 and 2 pi. So here are my other two answers, pi over 6, 7 pi over 6, pi over 3, 4 pi over 3. If I go back to the graph here, there's my pi over 6, there's 7 pi over 6, there's pi over 3, and there's 4 pi over 3. So we're getting the same answer in both cases, graphing and algebraically.